All right. Often on this program, we're discussing the far left and the fact that they've spent decades infiltrating the education system, social media, and the entertainment industry to target the hearts and minds of our children. Well, this week, join FRC for the Sake of Our Children's campaign to help stop leftist indoctrination. Reach the next generation with biblical truth and hope and protect America's future. Every gift will be quadruple up to our $1 million challenge match. All you have to do is text CHILD, that's C-H-I-L-D, CHILD, to 67742. Or, as always, you can visit TonyPerkins.com to partner with us. All right, with the focus on President Biden's $3.5 trillion Build Government Bigger plan, the normal spending bills are not getting much attention, and they should. Not for what is in them, but for what's not. Earlier this week, Senate Democrats released the 9 remaining appropriations bills for 2022, which have a price tag of roughly $1.5 trillion. Well, that means there are lots of dollars in these spending bills, 13% more than last year, to be exact. It's what's left out that may be more costly. From the appropriations to fund the Labor, Health and Human Services and Education Department, what's missing is the Hyde Amendment, which restricts taxpayer funding of abortion. Also absent is the Weldon Amendment, which prohibits federal funds from going to states that discriminate against any healthcare entity that does not want to pay for or provide coverage for abortions. What else is cause for concern? Well, joining us now to talk about this is U.S. Senator Steve Daines of Montana. He is the chairman of the Senate Pro-Life Caucus. He's also a member of the Senate Finance Committee. Senator, welcome back to the program.
Thanks, Tony.
All right, I want to get to the 9 appropriations bills that were released by Democrats on Monday, but first, what's the latest on the reconciliation bill? I see the Democrats are negotiating with themselves, going back and forth. It appears that they've moved off the $3.5 trillion, but where this thing lands, nobody knows.
Well, I don't think they know either, Tony. It's Dems in complete disarray. It's this donkey on donkey battling that we're watching. Is this the largest spending bill in our nation's history? This may be the largest tax increase in 50 years. They have still got a long ways to go to try to put their arms around this massive, reckless spending and tax bill. But what's not being talked about enough is the underlying policies. We talk about the numbers, you know, this $3.5 trillion number, the tax increase. These are terrible. But you start peeling back the policies, higher taxes for married couples. In other words, we're going to incentivize people to not get married. That is just flat out wrong. These Green New Deal policies that will bankrupt this country. Look what's going on in Europe with natural gas prices up nearly 400%, coal prices nearly doubling. Of course, oil prices up 70, 80%. This is the movie trailer. What we're seeing in Europe is the movie trailer of what will happen to America if these policies they're promoting here on the climate and the Green New Deal pass the Senate, the House, and get on President Biden's desk.
And Senator Daines, that seems to be one of the sticking points with one of your colleagues from West Virginia, Senator Manchin, who comes from a coal-rich state. He is pushing back on some of these Green New Deal policies. But of course, you have the progressive wing of the party, the extreme left in the House saying, we have to have these. Where does this end up at the end of the day?
Yeah, I don't think anybody knows, Tony. And I'll tell you, I'm glad to see some Democrats standing up and pushing back against these radical policies. Tony, these are radical, far left policies. This is a fundamental battle against Marxism and control of the economy and energy by the government instead of the free markets. You know, as America's led the world in reducing CO2 emissions because of innovation and free market principles, we've had reliable, affordable energy until the left takes charge of this country. And now Biden, you know, one hit back in January, we're shutting down the Keystone Pipeline, shutting down oil and gas leases on our federal lands. And now he's pleading with OPEC to increase production because we're seeing soaring gas prices.
Yeah, I do hope the American people see this. This is not complicated. You cut off pipelines, you shut down exploration and drilling in this country. And we were energy independent at the end of the Trump administration. And now we see the prices going up at the pump. We see, as you pointed out, this administration trying to negotiate with foreign entities to get more energy. What's behind this?
What's behind this, Tony, is the religion of the left. The religion of the left worships climate change and New Green Deal. That they wake up every morning dreaming about these policies. They worship more abortion policies. They are pro-abortion. I mean, they will fight to the last breath to ensure that we continue to have abortion on demand and that we shut down conventional sources of energy. It's a very, very dangerous Marxist type philosophy. It's godless. And that is the fight we've got going on right now in Washington. While we must stop it and look again no further than what Europe is doing right now as we speak. If you want to say a prayer at night, pray for a warmer winter for Europe, because they're on the verge of running out of energy. Because what they did is they decommissioned nuclear plants. They decommissioned coal fire plants. And you know what, Tony? They're out of energy and they've got a mess on their hands. We can't let that happen to the United States.
And what's amazing, Senator Daines, is all of this is done in the name of helping the middle class, the working man, when in fact he's the one that's going to carry the burden here with these policies that end up raising energy prices and driving up the cost of goods. I want to play a clip from Senator Schumer earlier today, and then we're going to move to the appropriations bills released earlier this week. Play clip number 5, please.
Everyone is going to have to compromise if we're going to find that legislative sweet spot we can all get behind. Nobody will get everything they want, but no matter what, our final proposal will deliver the core promise we made to the American people. We will take bold action against the climate crisis while creating millions of new good-paying jobs. We will expand economic opportunity and lower costs for working Americans. And we will cut taxes for working and middle-class Americans while asking the wealthy to pay their fair share.
How does he say that with a straight face?
Yeah, I tell you, how can you listen to that with a straight face? You know, when we had majority control in the Senate, when President Trump was in office, we cut taxes. We let the American people have more money in their pockets. And guess what happened? We saw a booming economy. We saw, you know, middle-class wages go up. We saw record levels, low levels of unemployment for minorities. And then the Democrats take over, and of course we see the wreckage leaving behind here with these far left policies. But when he talked about compromise, I just had to chuckle for a minute, Tony. Everybody's got a compromise. No, they're not asking Republicans to be involved in discussions. That is talking about 48 Democrats versus 2 Democrats, Manchin and Sinema. There's 50 Republicans that have been completely shut out of this process. Remember, there's 52 of us, 50 Republicans plus 2 Democrats, Manchin and Sinema, who have a problem with what's going on with this bill. It's the minority, it's 48 on the left Democrats that are supporting what Schumer's trying to do at the moment. Stay tuned. It's a long ways from over.
So, Senator, final on the reconciliation. In my view, I don't see a sweet spot out there.
No, I tell you, I think it's going to be very, very difficult for them. They have no margin for error. It's a 50-50 Senate, and they've got a 4-seat margin in the U.S. House. Just at the time when you start to maybe move a little bit to the left, then the moderates get mad, move a little bit to the right, the far left gets angry. I think they're going to have a hard time bringing this thing home.
All right, Senator. Since 1976, I believe, 75, 76, we've had the Hyde Amendment as an annual rider to our appropriations bills. That's been common ground. That's been a legislative sweet spot, if you will. Everybody's agreed to that, but not now. The House kicked it out, and then on Monday, when the Senate released its 9 remaining appropriations bills, it was gone. I would think that, unlike reconciliation, they have to have Republican help to get these appropriations bills forward. What's going on here?
Well, Tony, you're exactly right. And that's why after the election, I led a letter and had 47 Republican senators sign it that said, if the Hyde protections are removed, the bill is dead on arrival. And as you correctly articulated, for 45 years, that's been the law of the land. In other words, protecting taxpayer dollars from funding abortions. It's never been controversial. Joe Biden supported this back when he was a senator. So this is a purposeful exclusion of this provision. It's a blatant attack on life and taxpayers. This is a purely partisan effort. And thanks to that letter that we have with a commitment signed in ink by 47 of us, that would make it filibuster proof and dead on arrival if they try to do this through the regular order in the United States Senate.
We're going to be watching that one very closely because this is a life or death battle. Because we've seen millions of lives have been saved because of the Hyde Amendment. And Senator, we appreciate your leadership in the Senate leading the pro-life caucus. And as always, thanks for being with us today as well.
Thanks for having me, Tony.